I was in San Francisco. This is probably the things that I'll never forget in my life. Of course, it left a scar on my body. A lot of people ask me, Rikishi, what is that scar on your stomach? I got hit by a drive-by shooting in 1987. This was before I really got into the business. I was still trading, and I was at the wrong place at the wrong time. When I got hit, it felt like 30 seconds to a minute later, it felt like a hot blade that's been put on the stove and just put inside where they're just stabbing you slowly with it. That's what it felt. Where the bullet went in, that's where it really started to get hot. And I think I passed out, because when I realized I got shot, and I said, oh, God, I'm going to die. You know, I was just so young, you know. And I just seen my whole life, everything that, you know, I wanted to do, just went right by me. Next thing you know, I was in an ambulance. And before I closed my eyes, I seen my mother's face. That was the last face I seen. And when I came back to in the hospital, my wife and my kids were there. But my wife had told me that I had passed away for 3 minutes in the emergency room. And to this day, I think I was put back alive for a reason. I think to be able to give my family a better life, to be able to be here for my kids, and to be by my wife always. She's been a backbone of me. Tell me, don't ever say you can't do it. Go ahead, baby. You can do it. You can do it. So I owe a lot to my wife and my kids. I was in the hospital for about a month. And after getting out of the hospital for a month, I think that really opened my eyes up. What I'm really put back on this earth for. Me as Salofa Fatu Jr. has been through a lot here in the World Wrestling Federation. Again, with the roller coaster rides of different, I want to say I'm probably the only one with more characters than anybody here. When I first started, it was Samoan SWAT team again with me and my cousin Sam. Then we became the Head Shrinkers. After a couple years of that, I went off on the singles, did my own deal, which was Fatu, came out as myself. That didn't work out too good for me as far as being Fatu. So took time out, came back, a guy from the Middle East, the Sultan. That character didn't last too long. I asked him, well, Vince, where do we go from here? His thing to me was back to the chalkboard. So my career was starting to go down, sort of like this again. And when they sent me to Memphis, people haven't seen me in a while. And when I left this, being a Sultan, I was about 260 pounds, 270. When I came back, I was every bit of 4-something. They said, listen, you know, we got this idea that we would like for you to, you know, see if you're interested in. So I said, I wanted to do this with Yoko, but, you know, I think Yoko felt uncomfortable doing it, and so we never, but what I'm looking for is the real sumo deal. And I sort of knew where he was going with it. He says, I'm looking for the real. I said, okay, what do you got in mind there, boss? He said, well, I want you to be like the sumo guys that are out there, you know, the whole deal and everything like that. And I also want you, the thing I really want you to wear, the real, in other words, showing you, having your butt hang out, you know? So I'm sitting there and said, now me, my answer was, I don't care, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna feed my kids, do what it takes to take care of my family. But my only concern was my kids and my wife. My wife and kids didn't even think twice. They backed me up 100%. They said, Daddy, whatever you want to do, go ahead. Make that character come alive. Because this might be the character for you. I called the office. I said, hey, let's do this. I read, they said, well, Junior, are you really ready to? I said, Vince, I wouldn't do it if I didn't have my whole heart into it. I'm going to bring this character alive. So I went up. There's only a few things I would like to change, so if it's okay with you. He said, what's that? well, how about I be what a sumo wouldn't be? He said, well, what do you mean? I said, well, you don't see no blonde hair, bleach blonde hair sumos, do you? He said, well, okay. And then I sat there and I said, well, and also, would a sumo start dancing? No, I said, but we try that. The people, when I first took that skirt off, in front of the lights, 10,000 people, and I heard a lot of people laughing, you know. And that sort of made me feel funny, you know, like, okay, I feel like I'm a laughing stock of being out here, you know. So I go out there and I do all these things where my talent's starting to show. It's coming through. I'm coming with the Rikishi driver. I'm coming with backing that ass up. I'm coming with the bonsai. I'm coming with everything that I have. You know what happened? By the end of my match, people are doing this. Forgot all about my butt. So then I said, okay, now they respect me as my wrestling, but what do I do to be different? I want to get that entertained. I'm missing something. So I'm sitting there, when they raise my hand, my music started playing. I went up, just start dancing. Next thing you know, here goes a the crowd. They're all starting. And I'm like, okay, I think I've got something going on here. So there's when the dance was born. It was actually a blessing, because I was just doing the music made me move. And I was just out there just doing my thing, and the people were just with it. Yeah, I'm out there I'm got the biggest booty out there in World Wrestling Entertainment today, and who's ever think that my rump shaker would make me a good living today? My heritage is very important to me. To describe it as Samoan people are loving, caring, happy, go-lucky type of people. I think as of now, we are the biggest family in wrestling today. It starts from my uncle, High Chief Peter Maivia, who is Afonsika's brother. We have such greats from Jimmy Snuka, the Tonga Kid, Samu, Haku, the Barbarian. Now the Rock is, you know, Rock has really opened up my eyes as far as the entertainment to where it's gone to a new level. Yoko is related. His father is my mother's brother, which makes me and him first cousins. My best friend, my road partner, my brother. Somebody that makes me laugh all the time. Me and Yoko has been through a lot together. I miss Yoko a lot. Through the hard times and in my life, again with how my career went, Yokozuna struck big in the WWF at the time. He was one of the top superstars in the World Wrestling Federation for a while. In 93, I just had my newborn son, Joseph, who I nicknamed his middle name Yokozuna after Yoko. And it was so cold, I remember we were wrestling in the town and my wife called me and said, "Dan, honey, it's freezing out here." I said, "Oh, well, turn the heat on, what's wrong?" She says, "The heater doesn't work in the house and the baby's cold." So I'm sitting there and Yoko overheard me talking to my wife. He said, "What's wrong, brother?" I said, "Man, I'm having problems at home. Like my heater went out and stuff. And my baby, my newborn is." Said, "All right, you tell her don't worry about it here." He pulled out his checkbook right there, signed a check, gave it to me. I went home the next day. My kids had a heater. So it was little things like that. I said, "Man, I'll never forget." I never forget stuff like that that he's done for me many a time. That's not the only time. It's being so generous like that, and being generous to our whole family. Yoko's heart is sort of like my heart, to where we're the ones that are giving, you know. I guess that comes from the Fasamo again. You know, how our parents teach you, if one's weak, if one can't afford to get whoever's successful, whoever can afford it, you turn around and lend a helping hand to your cousin. Why? I think it's because of the way we were raised up. That's the Fasamo. That's the way it is. There is no changing. It's been like that for years, since generation on, generation on. Nobody starves by themselves. Nobody gets rich by themselves. It's either one way or another. he's a wonderful guy, and I miss him dearly. I want to say we were one of the first Samoans in San Francisco, and came from my grandfather. He used to live with my grandfather on Dublin Street.
Rakishi's grandfather is my father. My dad and my mom sort of like raised all of us up, including my sister, which is Rakishi's mother is my sister.
My grandfather is one of those grandfathers that you prayed every day.
My dad is a minister of the Samoan Church, and we are all raised up underneath. You won't believe some of the, there's so many of us that was raised up underneath that roof that my dad has down in San Francisco. In and out, I would say close to 37 people every day. It's something to see when you see all the grandchildren run in and out of the house and my father's place. It was, and Junior and Rakishi, that is, and most of all these brothers and sisters, they were like raised up in with my mother's and you know, in the same house that we live in.
I was part of the what we call the Alcohol Vo, was a youth group from my grandfather's church, and my Uncle Sipo, my Auntie Cokes, were the one that was in charge with the youth group. And that's where they had like Polynesian dancing and stuff like that, and I was a part of that. So that's where I think my skills as far as Samoan dancing came from. The thing is that I would, the way I was brought up is the number one, to learn the custom and so forth was just very, very important in our family, and also the Christian life is very important in our family. It was always on me. You know, I was a part of my grandfather's church and so forth. So my way is not no different how I raise my kids up. You know, I teach my kids, you treat people the way you want to be treated. The one word that sticks in my mind what my grandfather says is felofani, il oto felofani, and that means that you guys get along and love each other. So, and that's what continues from the oldest all the way down to my little baby Joseph. The reason why I think about my grandfather, he was a big inspiration in my life. He was a preacher again that was for the city of San Francisco, and he was a big part of my life, and to tell me to afayos, I'm gonna speak in some words, afayos emea, okay, Pisa, I fight. That means when you talk about something, son, do it. So all the dreams that I had as far as becoming a big star in professional wrestling, I want to thank my grandfather for it. You know, I made it. When he passed away and my grandmother passed away, we all pretty much, we have this thing where we have a family reunion, and we have it every other year now. And he pretty much still lives in all of us. His ways, it continues from my uncles and my mom, comes to me, and I continue to put it onto my kids. You don't really have to go back to the islands to do the ritual dance that we do. These dances are usually done when we are at a family reunion, happy things like that. This dance is called a kawalunga. When this song comes on, you get up and you dance to whoever the party is to. When you dance Samoan style, you dance telling the story by using your hands. So I'm gonna give you just a little bit of taste of what I learned through over the years that was taught to me from my uncles and my aunties, and to let everybody see a little bit of what I do. I want to be remembered as a guy that loved his family, a guy that his family is very, very close, and a guy that my sisters and my brothers, not only my wife, they have my heart.